The High Court on Monday refused to issue notices to MLAs Dayanand Sopte and Subhash Shirodkar. The court wanted the MGP to place proof indicating that they did not resign voluntarily before it. The matter has been kept for Friday for placing of evidence. The MGP had filed a petition before the court in what they say is a bid to instill some propriety in the system. The petition questioned that the way the resignation of the two Congress MLAs, Dayanand Sopte and Subhash Shirodkar, were submitted and subsequently accepted by the Speaker.
Court has not given any decision. Court has heard at length, and the matter has been simpliciter adjourned for the coming Friday to enable us to make the submissions. Present petition that has been filed by MG party deals with the issue, or the purpose behind the petition is to bring about purity in the process of democracy. Two MLAs belonging to which were elected on the ticket of Indian National Congress, that is respondent number 5 and 6 in the petition, while being continuing as a Congress members, met the national president of BJP in New Delhi. Now, while sitting in his office, they submitted the resignation letter addressed to the Speaker to the national president of BJP. Now, BJP office forwarded that letter, faxed that letter to the Speaker. Both the resignation letters were faxed to the Speaker from the BJP office itself. And without blink of an eye, the Speaker accepted both the resignation letters. Now, what we are trying to submit to the court is, at the relevant time when the resignation letters were submitted, the members were not before the Speaker. The letters have been faxed, so physical copy of the letters is not before the Speaker. So, and what article proviso to Article 190 Clause 3 provide for is an inquiry, which provides basically that if the Speaker, upon an inquiry conducted by the Speaker, if he comes to the conclusion that the resignation is not voluntary, then he should not accept the resignation. Our whole submission before the court is, the Speaker acts as a tribunal in such matters. He is required to conduct an inquiry about the genuineness, and overwhelming circumstances which were there before the court basically will point out that the resignations were accepted when they were with the BJP president or is in BJP office. They were personally not present. So unless the notice was issued to them, unless a notice was issued to the concerned party who is likely to get affected by it, resignation should not have been accepted. Now, in such an event, the court has granted us further time to give it the necessary material. Now, we have also recommended, we have also been pressing for recommendation by the High Court to the state to the Election Commission of India to make necessary amends to the to the anti-defection law, that in all such cases, basically the purpose of anti-defection law has to be understood, and this is basically one kind of a fraud on the Constitution. So necessary recommendations should be made to bring about reforms in the election matters. Now, court has granted us time. Matter is fixed on next Friday, coming Friday.
A video journalist Yashwant Parab in Padachi.